Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will consider a case study that will serve as an illustrative example for how we can use statistical inference to answer questions and draw conclusions from a dataset collected during a scientific experiment. The case study we will consider was conducted in 1972 as part of a study on gender discrimination. 48 male bank supervisors were each given the same personnel file and asked to judge whether the person should be promoted to a branch manager job that was described as routine. The personnel files were all identical, save for one detail. Half of the files presented the person as being male, and the other half presented the person as being female. It was randomly determined which supervisors would get the male applications and which ones would get the female applications. The experiment proceeded, and out of the 48 files reviewed, 35 were promoted. This study, as constructed, is an example of how you could test whether or not women are unfairly discriminated against in promotional decisions. It is also an example of a scientific experiment. There was only one variable, whether or not the personnel file said male or female, and the files were randomly distributed to the bank supervisors. How the promotions were distributed among the male and female personnel files is summarized in the following table. At a first glance, does there appear to be a relationship between promotion and gender? We see that 21 men were promoted and 14 women were promoted. When you are dealing with two categorical variables like this, male versus female, and promoted versus not promoted, the relevant metric that we want to take a look at is the percentage of men and women that were promoted. We construct the fractions and find that about 87.5% of men were promoted and about 58.3% of women were promoted. So we're seeing a difference of almost 30% between the proportion of male and female files that are promoted. Based on this information, which of the following statements is true? 1. If we were to repeat the experiment, we will definitely see that more female files get promoted. This was a fluke. 2. Promotion is dependent on gender. Males are more likely to be promoted, and hence there is gender discrimination against women in promotion decisions. 3. The difference in the proportions of promoted male and female files is due to chance. This is not evidence of gender discrimination against women in promotion decisions. 4. Women are less qualified than men, and this is why fewer women get promoted. Of these four statements, either statement 2 or 3 might be true. Coming to a firmer conclusion will require us to conduct a hypothesis test. As it turns out, the steps for conducting a hypothesis test resembles that of a trial in a court of law. We will rely on this analogy to explain the purpose and structure of hypothesis tests in the next video.